What's going on, everybody? I'm here with...
I gotta go.
All right, hey, do your thing.
I gotta go.
Thank you everybody for clicking on that video. But before we continue about Supreme, I gotta give a big shout out to Privacy.com. Privacy.com is a free app that is gonna allow you to buy things on the internet using a virtual credit card or debit card, so you don't have to use your real one. And that is actually gonna keep your bank information and your card information safe on the internet. You guys know, if you guys are into buying streetwear or sneakers, Cos figures, even Supreme, you guys know what I mean. But anyways, more on that later.
What's going on, everybody? I am here on Fairfax Ave. This is the center of streetwear here on the West Coast. I'm here to ask the question today. Is Supreme still cool? I'm gonna be talking to a lot of people today, industry insiders, people who are just random fans. Let's go see what they gotta say. Streetwear journalism on the street. When people think of streetwear, what's the brand they're thinking about?
I would say Supreme.
I definitely see a lot more people with Supreme nowadays.
Supreme.
Yeah.
Supreme for the culture.
Supreme, yeah. Probably Supreme.
Supreme or Louis.
Now, Supreme as a company is worth over $1 billion now. That's crazy. But some people still say that a lot of their items are flopping, they're kind of falling off, they're dying. What do you guys think?
No, those people that say that it fell off, I mean, come out here to Supreme Week on Thursdays, bro. Fairfax is cracking.
I think it's still hot. It's getting better, honestly, because more people is getting it, the younger kids too.
I really don't think it has fallen off, to be honest. I think the market is really saturated now, but for the demand for Supreme, it's just gone up every single year.
I don't know. I think it's just becoming more accessible. I think Supreme used to be way cooler back when it was older, earlier years, you know?
You know, a lot of people will wear Supreme and they don't really understand the brand.
I definitely think it's fallen off from where it used to be, like at the top with like the Louis V collab.
I definitely see a lot more people with Supreme nowadays. But I wouldn't say it's falling off necessarily.
Man, I definitely think it's falling off. I mean, the box logo is always a classy fit, but it's too flashy nowadays, too much, man.
I just think they need to get more creative so people stay interested in it. Switch it up more.
All right, guys, this is a question that you've talked about on your channel and a lot of people have talked about. I've seen it on Reddit. I've seen other YouTube videos about it. Is Supreme falling off? It's worth $1 billion.
It all determines what metric you are, you know, gonna measure it by. Is it sales or is it, you know, cultural relevancy? I would say Supreme maybe 2 years ago was on another level, in my opinion. 2017, I think it was on another level. I always answer the question with keeping it cultural relevancy in mind, cool points, who's rocking it right now. Yeah, I say it's dying.
Dying or falling off?
Falling, dying off, whatever, yeah. You know?
In decline.
In decline, in my opinion. I don't get that same wow factor when I see it now.
Maybe it's just because we live in LA, but I don't feel the same thing when I see a BMW anymore.
Exactly. I'm big on bang for your buck. It kind of reminds me of like the whole Yeezy wave. $500 for a pair of Yeezys don't get looked at twice. You look at them, you look away. But now, the same thing has happened with Supreme. When you need to spend $5,000 on one piece to get the recognition, that's when it's watered down.
As a current Supreme fan, does it hurt to see like other people wear it wrong or like so many other people wear it that like they're not really into it?
That's kind of the same with Jordans, for example. A lot of people don't know the history, but they still rock it. Man, I really don't think you really need to know the history about it to rock something. You know, just whatever you're comfortable with.
Yes and no. I think what's happened today is that these websites are now bringing Supreme online to where you can grab it and they're bringing it at a different price. So now it's, you kind of know what you see online to say, oh, I can just get that over there for so-and-so price.
Maybe 10 years ago, Supreme, they put their logos on stuff that they still could. Now they're just slapping it on literally every accessory they can think of. And they're just overcharging it. And then I feel like in the next 10 years, it's gonna go way down.
They just buy it because it's Supreme, you know?
Yeah. Describe somebody or something that you've seen where you were just like, oh, that like ruined Supreme for me.
Like Adidas joggers and then just like a box logo, just like nothing, and then maybe some like Walmart shoes. Like, come on, man.
All right, so more about privacy.com. This is for anybody who's a sneakerhead or anyone who's into copping resale items or collectibles. You guys know the feeling about coming across a site that you're not super familiar with. I mean, maybe people on the forums have used it or your friend has suggested it, but you're just not 100% sure. Privacy.com allows you to actually go ahead and pull that trigger at a low risk because you know your bank and card info will be protected by creating a virtual card number instead of using your real one. It's like giving your card a disguise. That's like one less thing you need to worry about. Plus, it's free to use. There is a Chrome extension to save time. There's skins for cards for the retailers you use the most often. And it even has a merchant versus burner card option where the burner card is only gonna work once for the amount that you set. So there is no way it gets charged more. All right, so this actually makes getting free trials super easy because you know how you need a card to sign up for the free trial, but you don't wanna run the risk of forgetting and then getting charged more. Actually, you can, privacy.com lets you create a card with even a limited amount for just $1, you know, just to get the free trial started. And then there's no way that card can get charged more than that. So it just costs $1 to get that free trial done. So the virtual card that you create can literally not get charged more. Plus, it's all organized in a very easy to use, aesthetically pleasing interface, guys, if you check it out. And if you are interested at all in trying privacy.com, please check out our unique link down below, privacy.com/fungbros. You will get $5 off of your first purchase. That is $5 free money.
I think it just comes down to consumerism. It's a little bit more like strategic now. People know no longer can you just get that go-to piece and be cool.
And I still like them because they're really expensive, but I feel like the Rolex Submariner GMTs kind of went that way, where it's like, it's still cool if you got one, but people are like, oh, it's not a Patek, it's not a...
Exactly.
Are we talking about something that just, it does this happen to everything?
Everything, I think.
Everything that's a consumeristic product.
We just dropped like four examples. And I think it happens anytime things are exposed and more people gravitate towards that specific brand, it's gonna happen.
I think definitely in this age of social media, it speeds everything up. Mm-hmm. Brands pop up and they can decline quicker. But see, Supreme was popping right before social media.
Yes.
But then for sure, everybody has a social media timeline, in my opinion, and it's about 6 to 7 years when you're popping on social media, because social media has been popping for about 10. Like the whole usage of it,
yeah,
you know, on your phone.
I see what you're saying.
So it's speeding everything up. Just like, I feel like Off-White doing pretty well right now. Mm-hmm. Right, everything's kind of killing it. But I could see the lifeline of Off-White even being shorter than Supreme in a way, because it came at the time of when everything's blowing up.
For sure.
With social media.
Yeah.
All right, last question, guys. Now that it's worth $1 billion, there's are a lot of rich people who own, let's just say, the world, that are now heavy stakeholders in Supreme.
I'm talking about like the 0.1%, 0.001%.
How are they going to prevent their investment from slipping, or that you think they're just going to sell it off when they feel it? Because I feel like they put so much control, from what I read, in James Jebbia's hands with his squad. And I heard he really surrounds himself with a lot of skaters, a lot of street kids, a lot of people who aren't like NBA, like business types, you know. How are they gonna like guarantee that their investment is sound?
Well, let him hang out with some more skaters.
Yeah.
Don't meet him, actually.
Right.
Stay away from him. They should not influence him.
Do not put any money around him so he could continue putting "fuck you" on his t-shirts and being happy with that. You know what I mean?
Even then, I heard that there is already some corporate, obviously, like gates and like limits that they had to like even put on.
It's for good reason.
Right.
It's to keep the essence of the brand.
Yeah, you're saying that the guys in the suits that own half the Supreme now want James Jebbia to stay with his street kid.
They'll understand when he says, stay away from me.
So do you think if the guy, let's say the suit goes in a Supreme, right? And his kid kind of had somebody be a little bit rude to him. You think he's not going to go, you guys need to have 5 out of 5 customer services? If you guys know, Supreme is notorious for having bad customer service because the workers are skaters.
Yes.
But that's why it's cool.
That's because it's cool.
There's people doing flips on skateboards in the back, and then they'll come out and ring up your socks.
Yep. I think culture is huge for any brand. It's that's hard.
True. And you know what? You guys heard it from the expert, Richie Lee himself.
Expert. I'm not an expert.
Or just a person with a lot of opinions.
I mean, this is what you do. You think about this stuff.
But we hit Fairfax, and we're about to, you know, find out what some people on Fairfax think.
What's something that you guys would not want to see Supreme do?
What really makes Supreme was the simplicity of the style. I really don't think they should do
you know, too much that is just kind of like all over the place.
Skechers, don't do that. Yeah, don't do that.
They stop dropping if they stop dropping stuff, items, they can put their name on a f***ing coffee maker and people are, you know, coming and buying that.
Like tire rims, like just random shit. Like you can't, it's gonna be hard to keep.
Crocs.
Yeah, like
Crocs. Yeah, Crocs. Crocs.
Starts dropping more BOGOs and it's definitely gonna drive down the price of their company.
Supreme MAGA hat. Yeah.
Maybe if they like branded an animal, some weird, maybe some weird shit like that.
Something like PETA with
Halo. Yeah.
What was like a Supreme piece that you particularly thought was really cool recently?
No, I think the BOGOs are sick. Starts dropping more BOGOs and it's definitely gonna drive down the price of their whole company. I like the one with the diamonds on it.
A lighter, water bottles.
I like the flask and the fanny pack was dope.
A little money shooter.
What's the coolest thing about Supreme?
I just think that it's just been around for so long, and I think the exclusive, how it was so exclusive before, has drawn that demand. So you know, people come and they want to buy it, they want to wear it because they believe that that's like, you know, you wear it, you're you know what I'm saying? Like it just
represents something cool.
Exactly, it just represents. So like when people wear it, you know, these kids are eating it all up. They want to wear it. They think, you know, that makes them cool. It's cool walking around with a Supreme shirt or walking around with some kind of keychain or something like that. Like that's all it is, bro.
It kind of reminds me when Instagram only had like 30 employees in just one office and they were worth as much as an airline. So it just goes to show you, it's not about the amount of locations, it's not the amount of employees or even the amount of product, it's branding. And let me tell you this, Supreme makes people feel cool. So, and it leads me to another question. How did Supreme get so cool? I don't even know who really has the answer to that, but if you guys got an answer, definitely leave it in the comments down below. Guys, that was another episode of Fun Grows on the Street, and until next time, I'm out. Peace. All right, everybody, thank you so much for watching that video, and big shout out to privacy.com for sponsoring it. Guys, if you know anybody, you or your friend that is interested and might be able to use it, click on our unique link down below, privacy.com/fungrows. You're gonna get $5 off of your first purchase. That means privacy.com is gonna give you $5, so that's kind of nice. But just for trying it, just check it out. It's free. Guys, privacy.com/fungrows. Again, thank you for watching that video, and until next time, I'm out. Peace. Yo, man, interviewing people on the street takes a lot of energy. I'm really hungry. So right now we're here at Bad Mash. We're about to go get some hipster Indian food. I heard it's delicious. In fact, I've actually had this before and it is delicious. Chili cheese naan. Wow. Whoa.